Hi guys, and a very good afternoon I bid to everyone, and also Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh I bid to everyone that is watching my video right now. Thank you for your time guys. So my name is Shahri Shami Hafiz bin Shamsul Bahrain. I am a year 1 forensic science student. My matric number is 147376. So my main purpose posting this video today is because of my IOP, or my individual oral presentation for my LSP 402 subject. So the topic of my presentation that I have chosen to present today is body language and inner thoughts. So in this presentation, I will prove to you guys that there is a correlation between your inner thoughts, which is in your mind, and also your body language. For example, your postures and also your facial expressions, alright? So let me begin my presentation today with the definitions of my topic. So my topic today is body language and also inner thoughts. So let me begin with the definition of body language. So this is from the book of body language, which is the science of reading and understanding body language. So body language is defined as the unspoken element of communication that we use to reveal our true feelings and also emotion. For example, our gestures, our body postures, and also our facial expressions, and not to forget our eye movement. These four examples of body language can actually give interpretation to other people about what we have or what we think or what we feel at the moment, because it is controlled by our mind, alright? So the second, the general definition of it is simply body language is a type of a non-verbal communication in which your physical behavior signify what you feel inside or what is in your mind, right? So that is body language. So what is inner thoughts? So I can simply say to you that inner thoughts is actually whatever that it is in your mind that controls your emotions and that they and some other things. So these kind of things can be portrayed by your facial expression, for example. So the next one, I will talk about the process of interpretation. So in this process, there are three elements. So the first one is the one that send the signal. For example, I'm talking with my friend, so he received the information from me, from my facial expression. So I am the source, so I am one of the element, the first element. So the second element is he himself, so he received from me, so he must be the receiver. And then the middle one, the second one, is actually the indication. What is indication? Indication is actually whatever I show, which is my body language, because he uses this to actually interpret my feeling, and the intonation of me speaking to him also plays a big role in the communication. Alright, so what are the correlation between inner thoughts and body language? I said to you guys just now that inner thoughts controls our body language, right? So let me start with one of the example of body language. The first one that I would like to be talking about is facial expression. So facial expression is actually whatever you show on your face. It is controlled by your facial muscle. Alright, let me show you guys an example. So this is a happy face. Right, a happy face. So if you see someone smiles to you, you can notice that, oh, this person is in a very good or happy mood today. So in your mind, you must be thinking of, alright, there must be something good happens to him, right? So that is your interpretation. So you get that from the signal that he gives to you, which is from the way that he smiled to you. So that is the indication that he gives out. So the indication comes from the one that give it, which is the person himself, right? So it comes from his inner thoughts because he feels happy on that day. So that is the correlation. The second one, if I show to you guys this picture, this is not a happy person. This is a sad person. If you see someone with that kind of face, for example, he doesn't smile to you, or he look like he just cried all night long, so it gives you an indication that that person is not in a good shape. You must be thinking of, alright, what causes him to feel sad on that day, right? And then the indication that he gives to you is actually from his face, from his sad face. And you notice that and your brain quickly interpret it as, okay, this person is in a very sad mood, right? Alright, so that is the correlation. So I want to show you guys about the another one, which is the eye contact. So you guys have to know that eye contact play a very big role as well in communication. This is our eyes, and when we talk to other people, we tend to actually see through the eyes. So it signifies, or it indicates, the honesty of a person. I give you a simple trick. If you talk to someone and that someone simply doesn't look into your eyes back, that means that person is actually hiding something from you. You must be careful with that. Alright, so I'm going to tell you guys where does this kind of thing comes from. It comes from our brain. This is our cerebellum, if you can see. So the cerebellum control the unconscious movement or unconscious motor movement of body. So it comes from our inner thoughts, and the cerebellum quickly give instruction to our body muscle, for example facial muscles, to actually portray what we feel on that day or what is in our mind. So in conclusion, there is a big correlation between our inner thoughts and also our body language, and it can also influence our conversation or contact with other people. With this, I end my presentation. Thank you for your time. Bye.